evening. This is Dr. Marissa reporting live at the Intercontinental Hotel, the second and last day of Ryan Long's two-day wealth summit. Yep. And I'm here with the man of the hour, the year, the summit, the gala, the man who went like this to John Travolta, and his name is Greg Reid. He's a friend of mine. He's a fabulous human being.
Thank you.
He's done so much wonderful stuff in his life, the present-day Napoleon Hill, and we have a new friend here that's going to be doing some work with him who came and introduced herself to me. So we're just going to have a little powwow right now and pretend we're at my studio.
Yeah, we really are friends. That's the best thing about it.
So,
we're all coming together, kumbaya.
It is wonderful. So are you tired? You've been on and off stage running up and down.
Yeah, you say I'm the man of the hour. I'm the man of the about half hour I'll be taking a nap. I gotta get one in. But, you know, it's interesting that, you know, the audience gives you so much life and so much energy even when you start draining yourself. And I gotta tell you, it feeds me and it feeds my soul.
Beautiful. So you've been asking everybody what's your takeaway from the speakers. So what's your takeaway that you're taking away from this weekend?
I would say that we're a reflection of the people we hang around the most. Our income, attitude, and lifestyle is the average of the group. If you hang around champions, you become one too. I mean, that's why I hang out with this young lady right here. She's going to be a star of my next movie.
Wonderful. And your name is?
Juliana Betancourt. I'm an actress and producer, and I have the pleasure to meet Greg in this beautiful, beautiful gala that we're having this week. And it's all about connections. It's all about love and making things happen and make business and make the things better for the world. So it's amazing time.
So
you're amazing.
Aw, thank you. I learned in Morocco, it takes beauty to see beauty, so it takes fabulous to see fabulous, right?
Yeah.
So you actually, I'm going to ask you the same question that I asked Greg. What's your biggest takeaway from listening to the speakers inside?
Definitely, you can be successful, but you can be loving at the same time. So it's not like you have to pick one on another one. It's just both together.
And I love you're from Colombia. What is the one thing that you love the most about Colombia and the most about the United States?
Okay, I love about Colombia the passion that we have for everything.
But you seem so relaxed all the time.
I know.
Sarcasm is another service that he offers, not just me.
And definitely in USA that we are all together here. People from everywhere in the world. And you just receive us with open arms. That's beautiful.
It is a beautiful place. It's a beautiful country. We're already great, and that's all I'll say about that. Greg, what have you got coming up? I know you've got a movie coming up, all that. You're too busy to come to the studio, so this is your interview. What are you doing?
Well, we got the Wishman movie coming out. Yeah. We're excited. We're in post-production right now. Should be released, I believe, in September. It's a story about the founder of the Make-A-Wish Foundation. Unbelievable how this has turned out. And we're going through all the editing right now. It's really interesting to see your vision come to life. You know, when you write a book, it comes on the pages, but it's not the same thing. But when you see actually the visuality of the actors portraying these roles, absolutely spectacular.
Yeah. I actually got to do a soundbite with Frank in Chicago at Soldier's Field. And we were speaking at the same event. And he's very excited about the movie. I'm very happy for you on that. And coming up is another Secret Knocks. Can you say anything about it?
Yeah, I got to tell you, Secret Knock coming up is going to be unbelievable. We have everyone coming in. I want to tell everyone who's coming in, but I will say this. We have one of the greatest chief medical scientific minds of today's modern generation. But then we have fun folks, too. Have you ever heard of the board game Pictionary? That's right. We got the guy who actually invented it. We have the founder of UGG Boots all the way to the founder of Make-A-Wish. It's going to be spectacular.
Can't wait to be there again. You know, I actually got a photo credit from your event in Forbes when he brought over Ed Snowden, I mean by web, but that interview was fabulous. So, Greg, thanks for all that you do, all that you continue to do. Glad we're friends, and the new friends too. You know, at the end of every show, yeah, he's ready. It's all about balance.